Right here on this page, download the OBS Virtual Cam plugin, which will be down below in the description. Then click on Go to Download. After it's done downloading, click on the download and set it up. After you have set it up, restart your computer and then reload OBS Studio. Once you are in OBS Studio, in the tab menu, click on Tools. Under Scripts, click on Virtual Cam. If you are a teacher and you're going to be using Virtual Cam all the time, click on Auto Start and Keep Aspect Ratio. This will make sure that anything going into the output from OBS Studio will be in a correct ratio and not stretched. Down below you will see buffered frames. Make sure that is set on the number 3. Now if you have Zoom, go into the Zoom software and click on the setting icon. Then click on Video under General. Right here it's going to be showing your current camera, but you want it to be on OBS Studio. So click on your webcam name and change it to OBS Camera. Below it, click on where it says HD, High Definition. All of the other settings here is what you will decide because that is your own webcam and that will be your own preference. At this time, you could also see that OBS Studio version 26.0 had it placed an official virtual cam. So you could just use that instead, but anyways, I think this is going to be informational for you. In Google Meet, make sure you click on Allow for Google to have access towards your microphone and your webcam. Click on the 3 dots under Captions, then click on Settings. After you click on Settings, click on Video and change your current camera to OBS Camera, Camera, or OBS Virtual Camera. Change your send resolution or output resolution to the high definition at 720p. Thanks for subscribing, and if you're new to OBS, go ahead and check out this video about all of the OBS settings.